have a suspended frame. Now this frame in particular is difficult to get it completely horizontal because the concurrent point has to be directly above the center of mass. Now let's check if the line of action of the rope goes through the line of action of center of mass. Now that we checked that it does, let's find the location of the concurrent point. We already know the coordinates from the flat plane. Now let's find the height of the concurrent point. Now let's solve for the tension of the ropes.
The frame is suspended above the XY plane, with the origin directly below the center of mass of the frame. It's very helpful to establish the coordinate systems at the beginning of an analysis for easier calculations as we solve for the rope tensions. Label points of interest and determine coordinates at each point. These coordinates were measured in inches. The concurrent point at D is directly above the center of mass and the origin. The vector W representing the weight of the steel frame is at the center of mass with its vertical line of action. Using a cut line to isolate a free body diagram, replace the top rope with the force vector FD. Using the equilibrium equations, compute FD. Now look at the frame. The ropes tied at points A, B, and C are in tension. The forces are upward in the direction of the ropes. Look at the steel ring. The ropes tied at point D are still in tension. The forces are downward in the direction of the ropes. So either free body diagram works. Let's use the cut line to isolate the steel ring and replace the cut ropes with force vectors having lines of actions in the directions of the ropes. To find these lines of action, compute the direction cosines using the coordinates measured earlier. Return to the suspended frame. Reference the coordinates of each point to compute radial vectors, sometimes called position vectors. Let's do one. Radial vector RA is found by subtracting the coordinates at the tail of the vector from the coordinates at the arrow tip. The direction of vector RA defines the direction of the force vector FA. Solve for vector RA and do the same to find RB and RC as well. Next, we need to normalize these vectors. That means to change them into unit vectors. Let's normalize RA. Review 3D unit vector video details. The unit vector is used as a pointer that defines the direction and the line of action of the force vector FA, which is along the rope. Notice that the units cancel, leaving the unit vector without units. That's normalizing. Now calculate values for the direction cosines and normalize vectors RB and RC. These unit vectors are pointers that define the direction and line of actions of the force vectors. Solve for the force FA by scaling the unit vector by the magnitude of the force vector FA. Using the regular FA without the vector symbol to represent the magnitude of force FA. Then multiply through with FA. Continue solving for forces FB and FC. include the force FD pulling upward at point D. Since vector FD has units of pounds, the magnitude of FA, FB, and FC will be in pounds as well. Now that we have vector components, apply the equations of equilibrium. The sum of the forces in the x directions is the sum of the I components. The sum of the forces in the y direction is the sum of the j components. And the sum of the forces in the z direction is the sum of the k components. Now there are three equations with three unknowns. Use your favorite method to solve for FA, FB, and FC. These are the magnitudes of the tensions in each rope. But let's verify that these are correct by substituting these values back into the vector equations. Check for equilibrium. So these are correct, and now summarize the solution. All ropes are in tension. The problem is done.